The squat and the deadlift are often at the center of the debate as to what represents the king of the lifts. In the search to find the ultimate test of human achievement, we are drawn to the movements that require the most brawn, grit, courage, and commitment to show us signs of what the individual is made of. But I would argue strongly that the main contender is not between the squat and the deadlift, but actually between the overhead press and everything else. There are a few movements that will test someone, as much as when they are trying to explosively and in one prayer-filled moment punch hundreds of pounds of metal directly over their cranium, with only the small joints of the wrist and elbow being the thing between them and a traumatic brain injury. Developing a big press requires the coordination of every structure in your body in a single violent expression. It requires explosion from the legs and the hips, support from the trunk and the upper back. It requires horsepower from the shoulders and arms, and most importantly, it requires unwavering faith in the end result. There's a reason that a thick neck, large traps, and cannonball delts are met with respect and trepidation. They are a hallmark of every formidable athlete and a clear sign to those unfamiliar that the individual is capable of shoving, punching, pushing, and throwing, and that in the event that things escalate, if you get too close, you might not be able to get away again. And on that note, I want to cover some of the biggest pressing monsters you've never heard of. Some of these are people I've competed against directly. Some of them compete way out of my wheelhouse, so I can only stand on the sidelines and gasp in awe at the disgusting feats of strength that they display. The fact that these guys don't have more of a following or that their feats aren't more well-known is absolutely criminal, so we're going to remedy that today. Then we're back to Cambi, and he is fighting to stabilize this thing, giving it a pump and missing, and then having to restabilize it going again. Very small instance of success after that. And of course he gets it. 285 pounds because it's Nic Cambi. And he follows it up with some very Cambi-ish antics. I actually started doing work off the blocks because of him. He has an Olympic lifting background, so he's always doing stuff off the blocks. This is a 315 for four strict press, which is extremely impressive for the weight, but every one is coming from the bottom position. So that's a ton of horsepower. He's just gotten so strong over the last few years, and that's why he has the log and axle record. But I really like the lack of eccentric, being able to let it fall. Feels like you can get a lot more work in there. What's this? We have a 231-pound strongman with a 315 strict press? Dude, that's pretty impressive. That's noteworthy. Oh wait, that was an old video. Oh, he actually did it with 410. This is Jesse Nelson, who I've competed against a couple times. The first thing I ever learned about Jesse is that he can press anything over his head as long as he doesn't have to use his legs. Jesse's from West Virginia, which explains why he looks like a miner from Claim Jumper before they sold out and went corporate. Weight floating up by his chin, leans back, ample amount of bend. He calls it a standing bench press, which I appreciate the humor that he applies to that, but no matter how much back lean you do, the amount of total body power you need to get that over your head, especially at that weight. And you see how lean he is? Jesse walks around at like 235. So you got guys like me that have to cut way down. The dude is lean and he just has so much power and density. Here's Jesse with a 250-pound circus dumbbell press. I'm amazed he even uses legs here because he's even said he's worse with his legs. He had a 415 log. It was a record attempt at the time. And he approached it the exact same way. He narrowly missed it, and he missed it at lockout. He got it 3/4 of the way up, leaning back and pushing it away from himself. But it's just insane. I would actually put Jesse Nelson as a stronger presser than Nicholas Cambi, but Cambi just has the skill and the technique. But Jesse has like the power for a 500-pound push press. It's just absolutely nuts. Then here's a stupid bench press, 560 from a guy who doesn't compete in the bench press. I mean, this isn't even really necessary in strongman circles. So the fact that he just carries around that excess strength is ridiculous. And here's Tommy Sharp. Competed against Tommy a few times. He's from Waco, close by. This is a 280-pound circus dumbbell in training. And he just hits it like butter. He actually hit that a lot easier than Cambi hit his 285 record. Tommy was at the America's Strongest Man contest where that record was going down, and he just smoked 260. And my understanding is he got 285 with a very easy clean and just missed stabilizing it at lockout. So Tommy is another nasty athlete. I think of him as a little Kielszkowski because he has kind of the same profile. He can press anything over his head. He is extremely explosive on the taller side for the division and can move with anything. The only thing that holds him back is his deadlift, but his deadlift is still damn good anywhere else he would go. It's just in the ranks of everybody having an 800 plus pound pull, his deadlift is what holds him back. I want to give a quick shout out to BOOSTCAMP. If you haven't heard of them, it is an extremely cool platform. It is absolutely free to use. They actually sold me on the partnership when they mentioned who they're already associated with. They have guys like Greg Knuckles and Johnny Candido and Cody Lefevre. These are people I have a ton of respect for and who have done a lot of really good things in the industry. So they have programs up there. They also have exclusive programs. I have a brand new one coming out. It's going to be exclusive to their program. It's going to be for a fee, but it is a do strongman in any gym type of program. It's going to give you the physicality, the strength, the endurance, using really just a barbell, dumbbells, and whatever machines you see at a 24-hour fitness. So go ahead and check that out. Now we're into the heavies. This is Marcus Crowder, who by the looks of it has taken on the role of the lead figure of the Permabulk body positivity movement. A lot of shirtless standing pressing videos from Marcus. But Marcus also has more 400-pound strict press videos on his Instagram than anybody I've ever seen. This is 335 for like an easy five on log strict presses. Here he is strict pressing 405 for reps, just leaning back, straight line overhead. Just the shoulder and tricep power is absolutely nuts. And that's on par with some of the best guys in the world. Ty Cotton, this is another heavyweight. I saw this attempt at Clash on the Coast. This is one of the most impressive things I've ever seen. A 440 log, missed it overhead, regrouped, and within the time limit, cleaned it and pressed it again. This was essentially a double with a 440 log. That's outside, open sky, eyes into the sun. Everybody was having stabilization issues. If you haven't pressed a log outside, it's one of the worst things in the world. You could fall 10 or 20% short of your training numbers just because you're getting rocked around on your heels. You have no frame of reference. So guys were missing big attempts. To put the cherry on top, here is a Viper press. That's legitimately some world-class pressing strength right there. That's insane. Now you might've seen this guy on a couple of channels. He has a decent Instagram presence. Zach Tellender has featured him a couple of times. This is Graciano Rubio, or better known as Wall Street Weightlifter. And I hope Nic Cambi is watching this, because for as dominant as he is in that division, especially in the overhead press where he has like all the records, never forget, it can always get taken away. There's always going to be somebody nipping at your heels, reminding you that if you let yourself slip a little bit, that title can get taken from you. Graciano is legitimately the heir to the middleweight pressing throne if he ever competed in strongman. I never saw him compete after he got his pro card way back when, but he's still getting after it. He does a lot of Olympic lifting stuff on his Instagram channel. And just like Cambi, that Olympic lifting background fuels a lot of the just insane feats that he's capable of doing. And then lastly, we're going to go back a little bit to some of the wee lifters. I don't feature a lot of the really small guys, but this is CJ Pierce. He's a buddy of mine. CJ was a 198, and he was a guy that as a 198 would go into a contest as a middleweight and make all the 231s nervous. Because it's one thing to get beaten by the best guys around, but when a competitor in a lower weight class steps up and takes your lunch money, holy hell, does that ruin your weekend. But this is the 198 axle clean and press record. Now, historically, guys hate the axle because cleaning it's very difficult. Watch this clean that CJ pulls off right here. Watch for a smaller guy how just fluid and efficient it is. Just three quick pops and it's there, and he doesn't wait. He hits a quick jerk. You can barely call that a split. He gets his one leg back a little bit, but the power that CJ demonstrates is absolutely insane. So hopefully this gave you a little bit of inspiration. Hopefully it gave you some clear benchmarks on what these different levels of athletes are capable of. Let me know in the comments what you thought. Who is most impressive here? Let us know what the most impressive overhead pressing you've seen in real life is. And let us know what numbers are on your bucket list. Before we go, I want to let you guys know that the full interviews with Zach Tellender and John Hack are available right now on YouTube. Those have been up for a couple of weeks on Patreon. So if you want to see interviews early, if you want to see my training, which gets uploaded daily with commentary, or if you have questions for me, Patreon is the absolute best way to get in contact with me. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Until next time, this is Bromley. I'll see you.